start with the dolphin pose, which is used most often in yoga. They're going to come down onto their forearms, making sure that their fingers are spread, pressing down to the floor as much as possible. From there, they're going to tuck their toes, straighten their knees, lifting their bums up to the ceiling. Good. And we're going to try and just walk our toes in as much as we can, keeping our back nice and flat. And you want to make sure that their heads are looking towards the fingers and not collapsing. Go ahead and collapse for me. Like this, yes? So we want to make sure we're pressing down our shoulders and keeping our neck nice and long and pressing down into the floor. So from there, you can also add, you can lift your right leg up and hold. Hold for a few seconds. Test it with your students. We're going to lift up our left leg with the straight knees. And then we're going to come back down. So that was your first progression, is dolphin pose. Okay, your second progression, we're going to turn it around. So once your students get really comfortable with that one and build a little bit of shoulder strength and proper alignment, you can turn it around and we're going to do the same thing, but this time walking up the wall. So we say, oh, walk your feet up the wall. Make sure your ankles are squeezing together. So if I try to separate your legs, like we've talked about, it's nice and tight. From there, make sure their heads are still pressing down, shoulders are on the back, they can lift their right leg up and hold for a few seconds. But make sure it stays nice and straight, that it doesn't go too far over. Exactly. You want to make sure it stays nice and straight. And then left leg up. And then we're going to come on down. So that was your second progression for your forearm stand. Third progression, we're going to turn it back around, facing the wall. We're going to place our arms back down onto the floor, spreading our fingers, pressing down onto the floor, tucking our toes underneath us, so our knees are lifted off the floor. We have one foot to the front, one foot to the back. Okay, now I want you to think of not just kicking up against the wall, but rather think of lifting your legs up. So you're balancing, your balance point and your center of your body weight should be right here between the shoulder blades. Okay, so we want to make sure, next thing is to say, okay, now I want you to walk your, to spread your toes out as high as, sorry, not spread. I want you to lift your toes as much as you can up against the wall, as far up as you can. So this prevents them from sinking down into their backs, exactly what Sarah just did. She's going to push it back up and get those toes as high as possible. From there, you can start lifting off one foot at a time to find their balance. And again, they're squeezing their legs together and those inner thighs are nice and tight. So once your students get more comfortable with that, you can take it directly into the center and then you can practice balancing. Go ahead and show Sarah. So once they're feeling strong and confident, you can take it out to the center and start kicking.